and Harmony Concert in Lakawa. My name is Simon Choi. I'm the chairman for Lakawa. Since we don't have an MC, I'd like to also introduce in advance Reverend Douglas Ashbury. He'll open the second half with an introduction and a prayer. He's an accomplished musician there and very well respected peace activist. We look forward to his comments later on. We've been doing this Friendship and Harmony concert past 12 years. But tonight's concert is very special. The sincerity and urgency of our yearning for peace are unparalleled in our recent memories. All too often, anti-war demonstrations fall on deaf ears. Their emotional slogans become yet another sound and fury, signifying nothing. But I'm of a firm belief that the leaders of our nations and around the world cannot continue to ignore the will of their people, people like us, the citizens of a small planet called Earth. I believe our leaders today, that they need our prayers. They also need a strong push by their grassroots. Tonight we are here to make a heartfelt plea for peace. We will do so riding on the shoulders of our brave 140 musicians who are here today as Avengers of Peace. They represent 16 different nations. Some of their countries of origin are directly involved in our current conflict. And there are many more of them around our nation and all over the world. I believe the interfaith and transcultural events like this will serve as a living testimony that people from all different backgrounds can and must coexist peacefully. And this strong message for friendship and harmony can be exported back to where it's needed the most, in a form of reverse diaspora. Tonight, I dare to compare our musicians and our friends here today to those people who were present in Mark's attic, Magai Tarakwan, 2,000 years ago. When the spirit descended upon them, the people from Judea, Rome, Crete, and Egypt, they were suddenly able to understand each other, and they began to spread the good news. We can not discuss peace without, Our musicians here tonight, people like Maestro Yun and his friends, they are possessed by the compelling spirit of peace. They all speak the universal language of friendship and harmony through music. On the other hand, builders of Babylonian Tower, who continue to pile up layers of human ambition and hubris, brick by brick, will fail. It will result in utter confusion and chaos. Religious leaders must refocus on salvation of the souls of their faithful. They should remind their people that they are the children of Abraham. They are the descendants of Ishmael and Isaac, and God blessed them both. I refuse to believe that any God will tell his follower to slaughter innocent people, especially children and women. Anyone who preaches such hatred and violence, shame on them. They are giving their religion a bad name. Politicians, please do your job of taking care of your own people, providing them with drinking water and safe roof over their head. All the religious and political leaders must realize before it's too late that they can lead no one if no one is following their lead. This all holds true in nations where human rights are being violated. Watch out, the new enlightened MZ generation is surging and their tide is turning. They're not prone to brainwashing and they will ask you the burning question, what have you done for me lately? And we musicians will want to be part of that new world order. You cannot stop it. You cannot reverse it. But don't listen to me. I'm just an average human being. But please listen to the words of the true leaders of our humanity. Mahatma Gandhi, fighting for independence, freedom of their nation, said this: for this cause, I too am prepared to die. But my friend, there is no cause for which I'm prepared to kill. We cannot discuss peace without remembering John F. Kennedy said, our problems are man-made, therefore can be solved by man. Let us create a new endeavor, new world of law, where strong must be just, and weak secure, and peace preserved. Finally, let us remember my favorite hero, Martin Luther King, a true freedom fighter against prejudice and bigotry. Yes, there was another civil rights leader, Malcolm X, actually, who made fun of him in his famous ballot or bullet speech. He mocked MLK for walking around singing "We Shall Overcome." He urged them to stop singing and start swinging, advocating militant fights. But Martin Luther King continued his nonviolent march for freedom and justice. I will end my greeting, borrowing words of MLK, only minimally paraphrased. One day, the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and the flesh shall see it together. And when this happens, all of God's children will be able to sing, "My country, it is of thee, sweet land of liberty. Land where our fathers died, land of pilgrims' pride, every mountainside." And all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Palestinians, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the old spiritual, "Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, you are free at last." Thank you.
Thank you. I want to promise you that Kampuchi, she's a crew member. Please welcome Lola Pat. Good job.
Thank you.
Cuban music, right? I will introduce a composer. Her name is Nakun Pek. Where is she? She's coming.
Egyptian and Syrian members playing together They provide a model for developing peace through a common devotion to music, as Lachman does. I'm confident that the efforts of many and varied small groups, as they grow steadily and with unity of purpose, will produce great results and can literally change history. As with the Verdi, the Brahms writing started from a small idea in the composer's mind. He had lost his mother, and he grieved over that. But over many years, it became the great music that we are about to hear today. Just so, let us not ignore our own small ideas that may promote peace, but let us work together for as long as it takes until we achieve our desired result. The daily news is filled with reports of the horrors and threats of war. However, efforts for peace are also continuing. Colin Erwin, who contributed greatly to peace in Northern Ireland, is currently visiting Israel and working for peace there. May there be leaders such as he who pursue peace there and elsewhere, so that friendship and harmony can be achieved throughout the world more quickly. Let us pray together that we and all of humanity will unite in pursuit of the ministry of